Shut up, pal.
What's up, people? I'm Jay Sean, and this is Billboard. You want to know something funny, right? I was in the studio, and I mess around so much when I'm in the studio. I do stupid things behind the mic and have fun. Producers always recording it anyway, just because we have stupid outtakes, which are a laugh. And as I finished the song, I started to do some reggae emceeing at the back, just as a joke. And then I went, wow, that would sound really cool if we got someone to actually do that. Like, someone like Sean Paul would be amazing on that. And then we all kind of looked at each other and actually, that would sound pretty hot. So then, honestly, as fate would have it, like a week later, we're at the VMAs, and Sean Paul, oddly enough, is right next to me. And he came up to me and said, what's up? And I went straight in, I went, yo, give me your number, because I have got a song for you. And he was like, yo, I'm up for that. So 2 days later, I sent the song to him, he sent it back, and it was done. Lil Jon's a good friend of ours, Cash Money and everything, and he was there for the fun factor and for the club factor and, you know, to give it that hype and that energy. And I mean, Lil Jon is just so much fun anyway, you know, and in real life, me, Sean and Jon, when we were at the video shoot for Do You Remember, we just had such a laugh. Two very successful people from America and meeting a brand new artist, yet we completely gelled, you know. There were no egos or anything clashing. It was great. See, here's the thing. I take my artistry very seriously. I believe that, you know, you can be the type of singer who just has great singles, bang, radio smash, radio smash, radio smash. But maybe people might not buy into you. You know, they just like your songs. They might not want to spend that $50 on coming to see you in concert, or that $10 to actually buy your whole album, or to even read about you in a magazine, or care enough. They just like your songs. Now me, I'm an artist and I take my artistry seriously. So for me, when I want people to buy into the album, to listen to the diversity on the album. You can hear painful songs, songs about heartbreak, songs about real life situations that I've been through, things like War, Lights Off, slow sexy songs like Do You on the album. You know, there's a whole variety of different songs, and that's what's important to me, is to let people see that. Hey, all of the times we had. Do you remember? So yeah, I mean, when Down went number one, I mean, of course, it's one of those moments where a dream literally presents itself in real life and goes, here you are, I'm here, you dreamt about this moment and it's here. And I took that moment and I put it away, and no one will ever be able to take that away from me. But I also knew that, I mean, come on, you can't expect every song you do to be a number one. That's just crazy, you know what I mean? And when I came with Do You Remember, I came with no expectations. I was like, look, I'm gonna put it out there, I love this song, and I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of people who like Down who would also like this, and new fans. And then when that went top 10 as well, I was just like, this is just such a great start to my career here in America, and I was just so thankful for that.